But before we begin, let's have a quick look at the headlines. Greek judiciary slammed for backing enemies of Turkey. Turkey leads humanitarian aid efforts to Rohingya refugees. Russian Foreign Ministry plans new U.S. sanctions. Trump cried as legal vows grow. And the U.S., U.K. and France on Tuesday once again condemned the use of chemical weapons by Bashar al-Assad regime in Syria. And now, the details of the news. The Greek judiciary has supported enemies of Turkey by granting asylum to coup plotters, the ruling Justice and Development AK Party said on Wednesday. In a Twitter post, AK Party spokesman Ömer Çelik said the Greek judiciary stands by the enemies of Turkey and coup plotters. This is a more severe and embracing stance than supporting terrorism. This statement came after Greece's General Council of State rejected the Greek government's appeal against the asylum of one of the 8 ex-Turkish soldiers who fled to Greece after the July 2016 defeated coup. We will never forget those who support terrorists with weapons and those who support them by judicial decisions, Çelik said, and added, the judiciary's decision to protect coup plotters in Greece, which itself suffered from coups in the past, shows that the law has been set aside. And he said that the Greek judiciary had taken the decision for other purposes. The General Council of State, which is the Supreme Administrative Court of Greece, made this decision on Süleyman Özkaynak's case Tuesday, setting a precedent for other cases involving 7 fugitive Turkish soldiers. A few hours after the July 2016 defeated coup to overthrow the Turkish government, 8 ex-military personnel had arrived in Greece on a hijacked Black Hawk helicopter and requested asylum. Turkey had immediately issued an extradition request, which was eventually declined by the Greek Supreme Court in January 2018 after a series of trials and appeals. Turkish authorities accused the soldiers of being involved in the defeated July 2016 coup and being members of the Fethullah terrorist organization. Turkish institutions remain at the forefront of providing aid to Rohingya refugees who fled Myanmar to Cox's Bazar in southeastern Bangladesh after a brutal military crackdown on August 25 last year. Turkish Cooperation and Coordination Agency, TİKA for short, Turkish Red Crescent, Turkey, the United Foundation, and Disaster Emergency Management Authority have made major contributions to help the persecuted Rohingya, including providing daily meals, shelters, healthcare, and education to tens of thousands of people.
The news continues on the English language broadcast of The Voice of Turkey.
Russian Deputy Foreign Minister Sergei Rybakov on Tuesday sharply criticized new U.S. sanctions against Russia linked to North Korea. The U.S. operates on the principle of the worse, the better, Rybakov said in a statement posted on the Russian Foreign Ministry website that detailed the sanctions for alleged violations of U.S. sanctions on North Korea. We oppose the stubborn, blinkered, and aggressive effort of the Americans to solve bilateral and international problems with a calm, methodical work on a constructive agenda, he said, and added, we responded and will respond so the sanctions in a manner that will not harm our own interests. The U.S. Treasury Department
sanctioned
two shipping companies, to Moya Maritime Logistics and Goodson Shipping, on August 21 that are accused of transferring petroleum products to North Korea in violation of UN-mandated caps on such imports. Six vessels are also affected, including the Patriot, Napkin, Bella, Partisan, Bogatri, and Sevastopol. Meanwhile, U.S. President Donald Trump held a campaign rally Tuesday in West Virginia, but made no mention of the big news of the day. Earlier in the day, Trump's former lawyer, Michael Cohen, pleaded guilty to campaign violations and thereby implicated the president in the scheme to pay hush money to a former adult film actress and a former magazine playmate. Almost at the same time as Cohen was pleading guilty in a New York courtroom, Trump's former campaign chief was found guilty in Virginia on 8 of 80 federal charges brought by special counsel Robert Mueller. At the rally, Trump retorted a familiar refrain to slam the probe led by Mueller on Russian interference in the 2016 presidential election. Fake news and the Russian witch hunt, Trump said. The normally combative Trump chose to highlight campaign issues his administration has been working since taking the office. The president made a bid to cement his administration's immigration policy, which has been criticized in the past. He mourned for separating children and families fleeing violence in Central and South America. He remarked about the murder of a white female college student whose death authorities said was committed by an undocumented immigrant. He did, however, not devote wider fake news than censorship of social media, a tool the president uses frequently. Trump has been holding rallies in increasing numbers over the past few weeks in the run-up to the midterm elections in November. The US, UK and France on Tuesday once again condemned the use of chemical weapons by Bashar al-Assad regime in Syria. In a joint statement on the occasion of the 5th anniversary of Ghouta stream gas attack in Damascus, which killed hundreds, the three countries said that since 2012, the regime has resorted to the use of chemical weapons during military offensives, not only in Ghouta, but also in Khan, Jamala, Parakit and Douma. At least 100 people were killed and hundreds of others injured in the chemical attack in April 2017 in Khan Sheikhoun in western Idlib province. As permanent members of the Security Council, we reaffirm our shared resolve to preventing the use of chemical weapons by the Syrian regime and for holding them accountable for any such use, said the statement. The US, UK and France said their position on the regime's use of chemical weapons is unchanged. And that was the news brought to you by the United States.